Okay, so let's see if we can figure out which wire this is on the schematic. So the red one, and then there's a yellow one also coming off there. Okay. Just looking back here. I think I figured out it was this 25 volt. Here. Well, this shows it as being attached to the bar. This is the moving part. Wait a sec, look closer. No, it goes to the middle fixed. Maybe that makes sense. The middle fixed non-moving part. Let's see here. So top is one of the non-moving. Yeah, so that's got to be it right there. 25 volts AC going through this contact. Through the cancel solenoid. These, yikes. All the way down to here. It's like J10 in the eighth. This would be number 8, right here. Number 8, it's not right at the back. So number 8 is this one here, and attached to it is a black wire. That looks to be not in good shape. I think that might be. This black one and the yellow one is moving up above. It's very awkward to do the video for this. I want to flip this module up and down and all around. Well, I'm pulling on this black one. Switch cameras again. I'm pulling on. It's hard to see, this black one. I can see when I pull it, the yellow one's moving back and forth with it. A yellow one. No doubt. They are stuck together. This yellow one here. They seem to move separately. Well, they do now. Okay, I don't think this is the charred wire. No, it's this. It's this blue wire. It's not even black. Wait a minute, I got the wrong one. I got the wrong wire here. This one. Yes, that is the charred wire that drops down. Drops down in there. Where does it go? Okay, that's right on one of the terminals of the relay. Oops. There you are. Yeah, let me go to the other camera. This is it here. It's going into 7, not 8. Going into 7, not 8. Am I huffing and puffing while I'm doing this? Let's see. Yeah, make sure I got the right terminal. This one, look at, there's a white wire that's just colored. Oh, it's not even connected there. this one. Ah, something must have gone wrong with that process there. I ended up nowhere where I thought I would. Let's see. Let's start again. Having trouble even being sure of just which pin to look at. It's so hard to see in here. I'm pulling on the burned wire itself. No, I'm not. I was grabbing on the wrong wire. A red wire. See the red wire? All wrecked up in there? That's the black wire. The red wire becomes the black wire after it burns. And its connection is right down in there. And that connection is pin number 7. Pin number 7. So pin number 7. the split. One, actually this connection point is actually right on the terminal here. One of these wires burned, this one, the one that goes over here. The other wire doesn't make a lot of sense, does it? Heads back to this part on the plug, pin number four. See any evidence of these wires overheating. The tape is curious. Number four, this one right here. There's nothing wrong with it. So the heavy current only went on a wire that is soldered to that point and goes over to here. And when it goes over here, it stops in a socket, receives a plug from another large component of the jukebox. Oh my gosh. So I would have thought this is a power supply, 25 volts DC. So this 25 volts, I would think, is a supply. So if this is the supply of the fault current that burned up the wire that's soldered to the top of this, then that current has to flow through this wire here, which is also soldered to the top of this. Same current, same kind of wire. Why would one burn and the other one not? Makes sense. Suggest some kind of fault rate in the actual working perfectly fine. What about that loose part? That doesn't look right, does it? Oh. It's kind of almost coming apart here. Something else that was loose. Maybe that was it. Yeah, that was it. Now, what are these capacitors doing here? Well, I'm going to be very quiet here while I study this, because that's what it requires. So, quiet study. So, I'll just stop right here.